Carleton in fall 2007. The longest paper I've ever written was the college essay and a 500 word essay for my general paper. That's something like an English paper in Singapore. So I came in without a lot of background in writing. And my first term at Carleton, I enrolled in a philosophy and psychology and a biology course. So I was tasked with writing a 10-page paper at the end of fall term, and that was very daunting for me.
But I've noticed that the American system of education, one thing it does is it makes people very articulate, and I've read papers and I've been like impressed on most occasions by how straightforward like papers are and how there is a lack of beating around the bush, as per se, because I feel as though I did that quite a bit. I would use all these flowery long sentences, or at least I would try to, and it just wouldn't work. Just the other day, I was showing Max one of my papers that I did when I was a freshman fall term, and the quality was just so much low, and I found myself like laughing at what I'd written.
So although I've never really seriously written a college level essay in my high school because it was a Chinese high school. But I thought, you know, the basic things should be similar, the way you develop your argument and how to stick with your thesis and, you know, support it with evidences. But after I arrived here, I found it's very different. Even though I knew the basics, but I found myself very easily distracted or even lost in writing some primary school level essays, because now that the grammar, the language itself is different. It was a high school, right? So like the essays I wrote were basically shorter than what I write here. And I tried to use the same way I write essays in high school here, but it doesn't work because the essays are now like really, really long and you need a very clear structure to keep it tight.
I don't think that it's possible to summarize simply the kinds of problems, because they're as different as the students are, and students have different experience with their English, with their formal English writing. And I'm very sensitive to the fact that these students aren't looking for special consideration. They want to be judged on an equal footing with all of their English-speaking, their native English-speaking peers, and I appreciate that. On the other hand, as a my discipline happens to be language instruction, and I know that it takes a very, very long time to get to that level of proficiency. So I would just encourage second language students at Carleton to talk with their professors and be realistic about how long it's going to take for them to develop a polished English prose, because the other secret is our native English speakers don't do it that well either, right? They have plenty of problems too. In fact, many of the second language writers that I work with know English grammar much better than our native English speakers do, but they're held back by idioms and things like that. So I don't think that their struggles with language are actually that much different than our native speaker struggles with language. It's that there's struggles in a different area.
The first class, I wasn't able to understand everyone. I didn't know what they're talking about, and I didn't understand the readings, and I didn't know. The prof asked us to make prep sheet, and didn't know what prep sheet it was. I even went to like Wikipedia, Google, to like, what's prep sheet? And it turns out to be preparation, like what you what you do for that. So language barrier, definitely.
And especially in Asian countries, we have, you know, like different value systems of being humble and not speaking directly. So coming here and having to, you know, throw out what I was going to say for the next 10 pages in the beginning paragraph, that was a little strange to me initially. But I think after a lot of practice, I got used to it.
Like, I guess I was stubborn with the way I wanted to write. And I thought, like, changing it completely wouldn't help me either. But I have changed it quite a bit now. And it was great. Like, the writing seminar really helped me. And so did the econ class, which was fairly writing intensive. And going from there, like, it's just been a upward trend. And even now, every paper I write, I feel myself. There are points I remember from the previous paper that I carry forward to the next one, and I consciously make an effort to change certain things.
So my first teacher or professor at Carleton, he was very encouraging of me, and he understood that I was coming from a different writing background. So he suggested that I did a draft a week or two before it was due, and I handed it to him. He read through, he gave me feedback, and talked about how I could better improve my thoughts and writing.